This is the unboxing and review of Cronova XPE498 home projector. El lunes, vamos a bailarlo, vamos a hacerlo.
It's Ricky Baker on the beat. Es difícil disimular lo que pasa por mi mente cuando te tengo de frente. Esas ganas de tocar ese cuerpo lentamente, divertirnos malamente con tu piel.
As well as an accessory box. In the accessory box. What's up everybody, my name is Sean, welcome to my tech channel. If this is the first time you're stopping by and you enjoy tech content, please consider subscribing and turn on the notification. This company, Cronova, sent me this home projector for me to review. This is the XPE498. In order for me to give you my honest opinion, I actually unboxed this yesterday. So let me tell you what's in the box and I will tell you the pros and cons of this unit. So when you open the box, you have the unit itself, as well as an accessory box. In the accessory box, you have the power cable. They have included an AV cable, as well as an HDMI cable, which is really nice, and the owner's manual. Now let's take a look at the unit itself. This unit, first of all, has two air intake and one exhaust. The two air intake, one is on the side of the lens itself, and one is in the back, and the exhaust fan is on the opposite side. So this is where you get the hot air coming out. So looking at the front, we have the lens cap, which you can take it off when you want to use it. It is made out of plastic. And when you look at this side, you have USB port and audio jack. You have your AV port and you have your HDMI port. And this is where the speaker is. If you look in the back, you have your VGA port, your SD card slot, as well as your power jack. And this is a Keystone slider. So when you have the projector exactly horizontal, then you don't really need to do anything. But the moment you actually attach the leg and you tilt up the projector, then the picture is going to be skewed a little bit. Then you will use the Keystone slider in the back to be able to adjust the view and how the image is being projected on the wall. Now, let me tell you about its specs. This has a 50,000 hour LED lamp. It projects up to 3200 lux. And just to note, lux is different than lumens. Whatever lux you get at about 11 inches from the source, that's how many lumens the light produces. But in a nutshell, it's fairly bright. You can also display up to 200 inches on your wall. However, the ideal distance that they recommend to have this away from your screen is about 8 feet or so. Because of the different ports you have, you can hook up anything through HDMI, such as your Xbox, PS4, Apple TV, and you can also use the USB port for some of the other devices, such as your Fire Stick. Now, let me tell you about my experience with this when I was testing this last night. I do not have a projector screen, so I could only project this on my wall. My wall is really light, but it is not white. That rhymes. My wall, it's kind of like an off-white eggshell color, but despite that, I was able to get decent quality when I turned the lights off. Now, with the lights on, this is not strong enough for you to be able to use it, at least in my experience. The image was not satisfactory at all when I had the lights on, so it has to be at nighttime, and you have to turn off the light naturally to be able to get usable quality from this unit. This produces fairly loud sound. The speaker in this thing is pretty loud, to the point I didn't really need to turn it up beyond halfway points when I was testing the unit. The menu also gives you the option whether you are projecting this from the ceiling, whether you're projecting from behind the screen, so you can flip through those fairly quickly. You can adjust the brightness, the color, and the sharpness. It also gives you options for noise reduction. This produces a 2000:1 contrast ratio, so the colors are fairly vivid, but you get the best quality out of it if you actually have a projector screen. When I was trying to use the SD card, I couldn't get it to work. I don't know if it was me, or if I was doing something wrong, but I wasn't able to get the SD card slot to work. When I hooked up my Apple TV, it worked very well. There are a lot of things I like about this unit. I think it's a nice compact unit. As you can see, it has an overall a good fit and finish. It produces loud volume and It's priced very reasonably. It's 90 bucks on Amazon, and right now they are offering a 10% coupon, so you get it almost for 80 bucks. You really can't go wrong with this. However, there are a couple of things that I didn't like about this unit. Number one, it is the focus ring that you have at the top of the unit. The ring focus, they're trying to match the color and quality of the body, but the problem is a little bit slippery. It's sometimes hard to get a good grip. I wish they actually used some sort of plastic material, so that way you will be able to control the focus much better. The other thing I didn't like about this unit is the moment you have this on an angle and you have to use the keystone slider to try to adjust the screen, then I could not get the screen to focus on all parts. For example, if I would get it to focus on the top, the bottom will be out of focus and vice versa. But if you don't use the stand and you have it flat on a table and you're happy with where the image is being dropped on the screen, then it focused much better. At the end of the day, you don't want to use this for anything text related, so for any kind of PowerPoint presentation, Word, Excel, or things like that. However, for gaming, watching movies, it will be just fine. So just a quick recap, some of the pros are the overall build quality, the price, the sound level, the number of ports it provides, and how small this is. This is only about 8.5 by 6.5 inches. And some of the cons are the focus and focus ring and how it works with the keystone slider. The overall brightness, you really cannot use it if the lights are turned on, which most people wouldn't use a projector in a lit room, but that's something to be aware of. And the overall picture quality is not suitable for all uses. It's best for watching movies and playing games. So this was it, guys. Thank you so much for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, please smack that like button. If you haven't subscribed yet, please consider doing so and turn on the notification. Comment down below, let me know what you guys think about this unit. If you decided to purchase one, I have the link down in the description below, and I will see you guys in the next one.